गुड मॉर्निंग टू यू ऑल. आई रुपेश कर्ण इन स्टैंडर्ड 4. जस्ट आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू द डिवीजन चैप्टर यूनिट. दिस चैप्टर इज ऑफ यूनिट 6. वॉट एवर द चैप्टर्स आई ऑलरेडी टॉट यू इन प्रीवियस क्लासेस, दोज आर वेरी यूजफुल फॉर यू. इन दिस चैप्टर डिवीजन, At first, we have to see this page. Concentrate here. Go through the topic. Just I teach you the best method to solve any division. Okay? Now see, in division, generally we see that suppose we have to divide 23 by 3. In this chapter, just we have to learn few terms, but you must concentrate regarding those terms. Now see, this 23 will be written first, and by which we divide, it is written at the last, and just we have to put here equal sign. And whatever the result will be there, you have to write there on. But if in this process, division can be expressed only if there is no remainder. See, this 23 will be written in the middle while doing the division, and this 3 will be written here. This 3, this part is called the division. Whatever the number we are going to divide, this is called dividend. This one is dividend. Dividend. How many times we divide, that is called, this part is called the quotient. Whatever the number, it will appear to us in this part, it is called quotient. And whatever the number at last we get after division, that is called remainder. Okay? Now see, by these, we make a formula there. See, how can we do this? Dividend equal to divisor. Divisor into quotient and plus remainder. Correct? Remainder. Suppose in the best example, just previously I divide 23 by 3. See here, 23, we have to divide 23 by 3. How can we divide? Now see, in divisor, only one digit is there. In case of dividend, two digits are here. Because in divisor, only one digit is there. So at first, we have to take one digit from the left. Correct? Not from the right. From the left, only one digit we should try to divide it. But here we see that this numerical value of 2 is less than the divisor. So, if we will go through the table of 3, even in one time we get 3 ones are 3, which is greater than the dividend number, so it cannot be divided. Then, in such a case, if more digits are present in dividend, see here 2 digits are here. Now, we have to take 23 together. Why we have taken 23 together? See, concentrate here. Because in one digit, only 2 is here. In 2, we can't divide by 3 because 2 is less than 3. While the rule states that, whatever the dividend must be at least equal to the divisor or more than the divisor, not less than. Correct? Here, such a situation arises because only one digit we have taken at first. Now, if it is not possible to divide at least one times, see here, previously I did not explain you regarding the division process, but at present I am going to explain you in details. The process, if you will come to know, you will never do any mistake in future in division. Correct? So here, in 2, if we will take one digit, here whatever it is 2, and 2 cannot be divided by 3, because if we will go through the table of 3, even in 1 times, it will its value will be more than the dividend. So we are free here to take 2 digits. If in 2 digits it is not possible to divide by the divisor, even one time, then we have to move on 3 digits. Means we have to take 3 digits at a time. But here 2 digits, 23 number is there, and 23 can be divided by 3 maximum up to 7 times, because 7 3 are 21. Write here 21. Give here minus sign because we are going to subtract here. Now 2 is the remainder. Here no remainder will be there. Now if more digits are present in dividend, we have to carry it one by one. Okay, but here there is no digit after 2 digits, so naturally 2 is the remainder here. In such a case, 2 is the remainder. Reminder, correct? 7 is the quotient, correct? Now see, so this division proves this rule. How? 23, in case of dividend we put here 23. Now in case of divisor we have to write here 3, in case of quotient we write here 7, and in case of remainder here we have to write 2. And because LHS is equal to RHS, see here 3 7s are 21 and plus 2 equal to 23, which is very very equal to the dividend. That means whatever division we perform here, it is most accurate. Correct. Some divisions are in decimal form also, but in the early stage, because you are in the fourth standard, so no division containing decimal answer is there. Okay, only in case of remainder, if it is just, you have to clear it. Now see, suppose one best example just I put here. Okay, by 12 we have to divide 354. Suppose one division just I do here. The process just I teach you how we perform the division process. Because here in case of divisor, 12 is written, that means we must have good concept about the table of 12. Okay, 12 ones are 12, 12 twos are 24, 12 threes are 36, 12 fours are 48, like this. Correct? And in division, you must know that at least one time we have to divide it, or maximum up to 9. Means either any number, any dividend is divided minimum up to 1 times and maximum up to 9. Means from, see here, if we divide like this, suppose one example is here, we have to divide 120 by 12. Suppose few students do this, like this question, like this 102 they are writing, and it is wrong process. Correct? This is wrong process. because I told you earlier that in case of division, minimum one time we have to divide it, or maximum up to 9, not x. That's this value at a time must not exceed than 9. That means if we have to divide 120 by 12, we should do like this process here. Because here two digits are here, we have to take two digits only. Because in divisor two digits are here, we have to take two digits from the dividend only and try to divide it. Naturally, here it is divisible because 12 ones are 12, it is divisible. So leave this zero at present. In the earlier stage, we should not take this zero together. 12 ones are 12. Now subtract this. Now zero is carried here because it is zero and there is no table of zero. There is no table of zero. So naturally, this zero will be here only. This zero is not coming because zero is carried by us and it is not possible to divide 0 by 12. That is why we put 0 here. See, concentrate your brain here. One example just I put before you. Okay. 121. See, in this case, what will happen? If we will have to divide it by 12. What will happen? See here. Because I taught you at present that division process starts from the divisor.